Hello everybody, this is Nintas Commander with episode 30 of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo Wii U. So, as you can see in this video, I am going to be playing as Pit, and since Sakurai tends to have a bit of a connection to the Kid Icarus franchise, with him directing Kid Icarus Uprising and, you know, other stuff Kid Icarus related, like Pit making his debut in the last game, I felt that even though a Sakurai topic would have been fitting in any Super Smash Bros. Video, I feel it's a bit extra satisfying if I actually play as a character that has more of a connection to Sakurai than other characters do. The only character I can think of that would have been even more fitting than Pit would have been Kirby, but I'm playing as Pit in this video, so I figured let's go ahead and talk about Sakurai. And the big question: should Sakurai stick around for the next Super Smash Bros.? Now, before I go into the direct question, I do want to start on the legacy that Smash Bros. Has given us. We've got four games of the series. The current iteration has two different versions, and needless to say, all of them have been pretty packed with content. The original game had the original 12 characters and a good chunk of stages. I haven't played it personally, but I can say that it does have a good chunk of content for people to sink their teeth into. Smash Bros. Melee was considered to be the first big step in bringing Super Smash Bros. To an all new level. Even to this day, Smash Bros. Melee is still played religiously. A lot of people still play that game, probably even more than any of the other iterations, including the current one. And Smash Bros. Brawl was considered to be a bit of a wonky trail. Some people really liked it, other people didn't like it as much as they did Melee. In fact, some people hated it compared to Melee. I understand why. I understand that Smash Bros. Brawl was kind of slowed down. In fact, it was very slowed down for what people have told me. I'm sorry, I haven't played Melee myself. I do want to fix that one day. But yeah, I didn't like Smash Bros. Brawl that much either, but I love the current version, and that's what brings us to the present. Now, each one of these games has strived to building upon what the previous game established and basically trying to advance it further. Some people considered Brawl to be a step back overall in terms of gameplay, maybe not content necessarily, but in terms of gameplay, people consider Brawl to be a step back, while Smash Bros. 4 is more of like a more enhanced version of Brawl, but I still don't think it's as fast as Melee is. Again, I can't say if I prefer Melee, but I doubt it. I absolutely adore the current iteration, and I've already said that twice, so sorry about that. Now, this legacy is pretty big. Considering it's only really four games, it's actually quite impressive to how much content each one has, especially when you consider how a couple of the sequels have managed to take what the previous game introduced and really build upon it. At this point now, I'm still amazed at how much content is packed inside Smash Bros. 4. You know, counting all the Miis as separate characters, we pretty much have almost 60 playable characters. That is incredible. Yes, some of them are clones, some of them are semi-clones, but whatever. In my opinion, that's incredible, and I never would have imagined that Sakurai and his team would have been able to have pulled that off. You know, I actually remember when Smash Bros. 4 was first announced, there was an announcement from Sakurai saying that the character count was going to be roughly the same as Smash Bros. Brawl, and this actually had me very disappointed because I was at least hoping there was going to be at least, say, 10 new characters on top of the ones that were already returning. So when I found out that there was only going to be about the same number, this kind of hurt my hype a bit. But now, obviously, well, I don't know if Sakurai and his team were able to implement more than they initially planned, or they were just trolling us as per usual. You know, I would even say that probably is the reason. But I'm still amazed at how far they went with this iteration. Now, this brings us to the question, this brings us to the present. Should Sakurai stick around? To me, if Sakurai was to continue right now, I feel that it's going to be a go for broke situation. Why do I say that? Because Sakurai isn't getting any younger. He's already in his 40s. He could even be approaching his 50. Yeah, his 50s by now. I don't know exactly how old he is, but I know he's in his 40s. He has already done so much for this franchise. And if I was to place myself in Sakurai's shoes, I would want to end it right here. I would want to end it on a high note, because there's no guarantees that the next Super Smash Bros. Is going to have as big of a roster as the current one is. Yeah, some people even theorize that there may be a reboot of the Smash Bros. Franchise with the next one, where they start right at the beginning, they ritually reboot everything, including the character roster, which is basically going to make it like maybe a slightly bigger of the original Smash Bros., but it's not going to have as many characters as, say, Melee or Brawl is going to have, or the current one. So, that's obviously another topic for another day, but if I was Sakurai, I'd want to end it right now. I would want to think, you know, I've done this, I've moved my way through 4 games, I've pushed myself so hard, I just want to end this on a high note and pass the franchise to someone else. Now, of course, this in itself could be a make it or break it situation, because the new person might make decisions that the crowd doesn't like. Maybe they'll tweak a lot of the basic signature elements of the franchise. Maybe they'll alter tilts. Maybe they will take out aerials or something silly like that. Maybe they'll change how Smash attacks are performed. They could change so much. It is quite incredible how much can change when you just simply change the director. We all saw what happened with Pokemon Sun and Moon, because people might not realize this, but after Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, after X and Y rather, the director for Pokemon actually changed. It changed apparently from the original to somebody new. Now, since ORAS were remakes, they can't really deviate too much from the original, because then they won't really be remakes. They'll be more rehashes or reimaginings. But with Sun and Moon, we've seen how drastically things have changed in terms of how the game was played through. There's no gyms. For a lot of the base elements, the gameplay is still roughly the same. They've just added stuff like Z moves, but the main thing you got to realize is a lot of the base elements has been changed and tweaked because of the change in direction, because of the change in a director. Smash Bros. Does have the same risk if Sakurai was to step down. Now, I'm not saying that changing the director would automatically be a bad thing. No. Sometimes it can be a good thing, because you can have a fresh take on a good franchise. You can have a fresh take on something that we have grown to love, which of course that in itself is a make it or break it situation. But if it's done properly, you know, it might find favor with most people. Of course, let's not kid ourselves. If the Smash Bros. Was to be revamped and they did change a lot of the base engine and really change how a lot of the stuff was to be done, yeah, there is going to be people that would complain about it. Let's not kid ourselves. There's going to be people that complain about it because it's not the Smash that they grew up with. Kind of like what happened to Fire Emblem, now that I think about it. Fire Emblem still has the same base gameplay, but in terms of how it's presented, it's changed quite a bit. A lot of things have been changed, a lot of staples have been dropped, and in general, the flow of the game these days is very different to how things worked back in the old school Fire Emblem. Now, from what I can see, Fire Emblem has mostly remained positive on the whole, but it still has people that are going to complain about it. And the same thing would happen with Smash if Smash was to get a revamp. Now you may think to yourself, well, Chris, why are you saying that Sakurai should retire or at least move away from Smash Brothers if this is the type of thing that can happen? Well, you see, the problem with that is if Sakurai is to continue making Super Smash Brothers, he could overexert himself, he could run out of ideas, or he could start showing his age. Now, please forgive me for saying this, but it's a very unpopular opinion that I have. But to me, if Sakurai was to stay around with what happened, if Sakurai is to stick around with Super Smash Bros., I fear he might go down a similar path to what happened with Shigeru Miyamoto. Now, don't get me wrong, Shigeru Miyamoto is a great game designer. He's made some great games over the years. He still makes good games, in my opinion, on the whole. But I also worry that the same thing could happen to Sakurai with Smash Brothers if he is going to continue down this path. Now, what do I mean by he'll go down the same path as Miyamoto? Well, Miyamoto, in my opinion, has kind of lost... He hasn't lost his touch. I just feel that he's not quite with the times anymore due to certain things he has decided upon as well as certain things he has said. Now, this isn't about Miyamoto. Don't get me wrong, I'm in no way saying Miyamoto is a bad game designer. That's definitely not the case. I still think he's a good game designer, but I don't think he's as good as he used to be. But with Sakurai, I worry that the same thing could happen with him. Of course, I'd rather be wrong. I'm not saying I'd like to be right at this sort of thing. If Sakurai can keep, maintaining things at the level he has been and keep improving the gameplay and keep adding more characters every installment, yeah, he should totally stay on board. But I just don't think he's going to be able to keep doing that because his age is going to catch up on him and the series fatigue might start setting in. He even already said that the main reason he left HAL Laboratory was because he didn't like how everybody assumed a sequel was coming with the Kirby games. So because of that, he felt the same thing was happening with Super Smash Bros. So, based on that, if he's already thinking that with, Kirby, then what does that say for Super Smash Bros.? You could have so much more with that type of franchise, because I don't think it's safe to say he put a lot more time into Smash than he did Kirby. Which, as for what he's working on right now, we don't exactly know. Could be a new Kid Icarus Uprising, a new Kid Icarus game. Could be the next Smash 4, we know. I don't know. But honestly, if it was down to me and I was in his shoes, I would say, call it quits, man. You've already given us so much. He's given us way more than I would have expected. Smash 4 ended up being a lot better than I originally thought it was going to be. And to me, I would want to pass the torch to someone else and go out on a high note. Unless I had some huge master plan in the works with Super Smash Bros. And I knew it was going to kick off really well and I really wanted to do it. If that's the situation, then yes, by all means, stick around because that's awesome. It's great that you're still pulling out these great ideas out of the hat. It's awesome. But if you're not fulfilling that anymore, then I think it's time to pass the torch to somebody else and let them have a crack at it. And plus, keep in mind, Smash Bros. Does have a pretty big legacy, so it's not like a new director doesn't have stuff that he can reference to get an idea of what he should be doing and what he should not be doing. So, there is also that. This is one of the reasons why I feel Pokemon has stayed strong even after changing its developer, because Pokemon has still stayed great, even with a change of developer. So, in my book, that is also good. So anyway, leave your thoughts in the comments down below, and if you've got a topic you want me to talk about in a future episode, then leave that there as well. So, see you guys next time. Bye-bye.